Hello students, this is the next lecture for TY BCom students. Name of the subject is Business Statistics, lecture number 96, unit 8, lecture 1. Name of the topic is Non-Parametric Tests. See, unit 8, Non-Parametric Tests. Number of lectures allocated are 8. See the syllabus, introduction. Sign test, run test, Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, Mann-Whitney test. This is the practical number 6 we are going to take. Introduction. Most of the hypothesis testing procedures are based on the assumptions that the random samples are selected from normal populations. But situations arise in practice in which such assumptions may not be justified. So, for non-normality, statisticians have devised various tests and methods that are independent of population distributions and parameters. These are called non-parametric tests. So, the first test which we are going to see is sign test. The sign test is used to test hypothesis on the population median and it checks whether the distribution is symmetric or not. The test procedure is described below. Step 1. Set up the hypothesis H0, population median mu is equal to mu0 against H1, population median mu not equal to mu0. Step 2. Given the random sample of size n, replace each sample value exceeding mu naught with a plus sign and each sample value less than mu naught with a minus sign. If the sample value matches with mu naught, then it is discarded and sample size n is reduced by 1. Step 3. Count the number of plus signs, say s plus, and number of minus signs, say s minus, and find S is equal to minimum of S plus and S minus. Step 4. Compare S with table value. Table values are given in the statistical table at alpha percent level of significance with corresponding value of N. Step 5. If S is greater than or equal to S alpha, H naught is accepted. Otherwise, reject H naught at alpha percent level of significance. See the example. The following data represent the number of hours that a rechargeable hedge trimmer operates before a recharge is required. The values are given 1.5, 2.2, 0.9, 1.3, 2.0, 1.6, 1.8, 1.5, 2.0, 1.2 and 1.7. Use the sign test to test the hypothesis at 5% level of significance that this particular trimmer operates with median of 1.8 hours before requiring a recharge. See the solution. Step 1. H0 is given as mu is equal to mu0 is equal to 1.8 against H1 mu not equal to mu0 not equal to 1.8. Step 2. Replacing each value by the symbol plus if it exceeds 1.8, by minus symbol if it is less than 1.8, and discarding the one measurement that equal 1.8. So we obtain the sequence. So 1.5 is less than 1.8, mun ite minus dile. 2.2 is greater than 1.8, mun plus dile. 0.9 is less than 1.8, mun minus. 1.3 is less than 1.8, so we will replace it by minus. 2.0 is greater than 1.8, it will be plus. 1.6 is less than 1.8, minus. 1.8 is equal to 1.8, we will discard this value. 1.5 is less than 1.8, so it is replaced by minus. 2.0 is greater than 1.8, so it will replace by plus. 1.02 is less than 1.8. Hence it is minus, and last value is 1.1 1.7. So 1.7 is also less than 1.8, it is replaced by minus. So as we discard this value, actually there are totally 11 values. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Out of 11, one value equals 1.8. So we will reduce sample size n by 1. So n becomes 10. S plus 1, 2 and 3. There are 3 plus signs. So S plus is equal to 3. S minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. S minus is 7. S is written as minimum of S plus and S minus. So minimum of 3 and 7. So answer will be 3. Now table value of S for 5% level of significance is 1. He kashi kadle tai value. See the table. आपल्या सायंटिस्टचा टेबल हवा आहे. एनची व्हॅल्यू आहे 10 आणि 5%ला एस अल्फा काढायचं आपल्याला. सो दिस इज क्रिटिकल व्हॅल्यूज ऑफ आर फॉर सायंटिस्ट. एनची व्हॅल्यू 10 आणि 5%ला व्हॅल्यू इज 1. सी 5% एस अल्फा व्हॅल्यू इज 1. आपली एसची व्हॅल्यू आली 3. सो S is equal to 3, S alpha is 1, so S is greater than S alpha, therefore we accept H naught. So the conclusion can be written as, the median operating time is not significantly different from 1.8 hours. Run test for testing randomness. So run can be defined, by run we mean an unbroken chain of sequences. Procedure of run test. Step 1. Set the hypothesis H0 that the sequence of outcomes is random. H1. The given sequence is not random. Step 2. If the sequence of quantitative measurements is given, then compare the values in pairs. If the succeeding value is greater than the preceding value, then put plus sign. Plus symbol, else put minus symbol. Step 3, count the number of plus symbols and symbols that say n1 and count number of minus symbols say n2. Step 4, count the number of runs of plus and minus symbols say capital R. Step 5, if the sequence of symbols is given, then count the number of runs R, number of symbols of first type n1, number of symbols of second type n2. Step 4, 5, 6, refer table for critical values of R in the run test and find the critical values for range of R. For example, in statistical table by University of Pune, refer page number 32, table number 1, and read the value of lower limit A for N1 and N2, and on the page number 33, table 2, read the value of upper limit B for N1 and N2 at 5% level of significance. Step 7, if the number of runs R lies in the range of A and B, both inclusive, that is if A is less than or equal to R, is less than or equal to B, then accept H0, otherwise reject it. See the example. 25 individuals were sampled as to whether they liked or did not like a product indicated Y and N. The resulting sample is shown by the following sequence: Y, N, Y, N, Y, N, N, Y, N, 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 Y, 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 N, N. Test at 5% level of significance whether the responses are random. See the solution. First of all, we will write null hypothesis that responses are random. H naught is responses are random. Against H1 can be written as responses are not random. We note that number of Y's, that is N, N1 is equal to 11, and number of N's, that is N2, is equal to 14. We count the number of runs. Y by is considered as one run. N, second run. Y, third run. N, fourth run. Y, fifth run. N, sixth run. Y, seventh run. N, eighth run. Y, ninth run. N, tenth run. So number of runs R is equal to 10. Now we have to find the values of A and B from table of critical values of R in the run test. Table 1, for N1 is equal to 11 and N2 is equal to 14. Let us see the value. See, N1 is equal to 11 and N2 is equal to 14. Value of A is 8. And for N1 is equal to 11 and N2 is equal to 14. Value of B is 19. So A is equal to 8 from table 1 and table 2 B is equal to 19 for N1 is equal to 11 and N2 is equal to 14. So value of A is 8. Number of runs we have counted, that is nothing but 10. Value of B we got 19. So A is less than R is less than B, because 8 is less than 10 is less than 19. So we accept H0 at 5% level of significance. So the conclusion can be written as sequence of responses is random. See the next example. The closing prices of stock on 20 days are given below. Determine at 5% level whether the prices are random. 10.375, 11.125, 10.875, 10.625, 11.50, 11.625, 11.25, 11.375, 10.75, 11.00, 10.875, 10.75, 11.50, 11.25, 12.125, 11.875, 11.375, 11.875, 11.125, and 11.75. See the solution. We set up the null hypothesis that prices are random. H0 is prices are random. Against H1, prices are not random. Comparing the values in pairs, we create the sequence of plus and minus symbols. See, we'll write the values in a column. 10.375. Next value is 11.125. As 11.125 is greater than 10.375, we will put plus sign. Next value is compared with 11.125. Next value is 10.875, which is less than 11.125. So we will put minus symbol. Next value is 10.625, which is less than 10.875. So again we are putting minus symbol. Next value is 11.50, which is greater than 10.625. So we are putting plus symbol. Next value is 11.625, which is greater than 11.50, so we are putting plus symbol. Next value is 11.25, which is less than 11.625, So we have to put minus symbol. 11.375 is greater than 11.25, so plus symbol will come. 10.75, which is less than 11.375, minus symbol will come. 11.00 is greater than 10.75, so we will put plus symbol. 10.875 is less than 11.00, so minus symbol will come. 10.75 is less than 10.875, so minus symbol will come. 11.50 is greater than 10.75, so plus symbol will come. Then 11.25 is less than 11.50, so minus symbol will come. 12.125 is greater than 11.25, so plus symbol will come. 11.875 is less than 12.125, minus symbol will come. 11.375 is less than 11.875, so minus symbol is coming. 11.875 is compared with 11.375, it is greater than the previous value, so plus symbol will come. 11.125 is less than 11.875, so minus symbol is coming. Last value is 11.75, which is greater than 11.125, so plus symbol has come. Now we will count the number of runs. 1 minus minus will constitute second run. Plus plus will give us third run. Minus fourth run. Plus fifth run. Minus 6th run, plus 7th run, minus minus 8th run, plus 9th run, minus 10th run, plus 11th run, minus minus will give us 12th run, plus 13th run, minus 14th run, and plus 15th run. So N1 is equal to number of plus symbols, which is equal to 9, and N2 is equal to number of minus symbols, which is equal to 10. And number of runs we have counted as 15. Now we have to find the values of A and B. From run test tables, N1 is equal to 9 and N2 is equal to 10. So N1 is equal to 9 and N2 is equal to 10. Value of A is equal to 6, and for N1 is equal to 9 and N2 is equal to 10. Value of B is 16. So value of A is 5 and value of B is 16. So since 5 is less than 15 is less than 16, we accept H0. So the conclusion can be written as the sequence of prices is random.